Hi, this is Mark from ShowMeCables, and today we are going to learn how to terminate a shielded RJ45 connector. For today's project, I'm going to need Cat5e shielded cable, two shielded RJ45 connectors, technician scissors, rotary strip tool, crimp tool, and a tester. The first step is to remove the jacket. Using my rotary strip tool, I rotate it around the outside of the jacket. That slices the jack and allows it to easily be pulled off. On the inside of the cable, you will immediately notice the foil shield. There might also be a ripcord. You can remove that by cutting the string. Pull back the foil and remove it. Under the foil, there should be a clear piece of cellophane plastic. Remove that by cutting or pulling. Then you will have access to the pairs. There are four pairs. They are color-coded. Untwist them, and now you will have eight individual wires or conductors. Begin to straighten them out with your hands and line them up to the appropriate color code. The color code dictates the order of the wires. For most standard straight-through applications, use the 568B color code. Since this is a shielded connector, we need the drain wire to come into contact with the connector. In this installation, we are going to divide the pairs in half, wrap the drain wire around four of the wires, and fold it over the back. Once we have done that, we are going to bring our wires together and trim them about half an inch from the jacket. Now slide on your RJ45 connector. Insert it into the crimp tool and crimp it down. This pinches the connector on the jacket. Trim back any exposed drain wire. To make a shielded patch cable, repeat all of these steps on the other side. The final step is to test our cable. Insert the RJ45 connectors into the tester. Please note, your tester might look slightly different. The green lights give us visual confirmation that we have successfully made and tested a Cat5e shielded patch cable.